Good morning, my dear friends. Today we are going to learn very interesting, easy but important topic, and name of the topic is infinitives, gerunds and participles. First of all, we will see infinitive. An infinitive is a base form of the verb and can occur with two or without two. It is form of two plus base verb. For example, to go, to come, to play. In the particular example, to go means go is verb. When we add to before go, it will become to go, means infinitive. Another example, come. Come is base form of the verb. When we have add to before come, it will become to come, means infinitive. And last example, play is base form. When we have add to before play, it will become to play. Infinitive functions as subject, object or complement of the verb. First of all, as a subject. Example, to tell stories is my hobby. In the particular example, to tell is infinitive, functions as a subject. Second, as an object. See the example, he wants to become a teacher. In the particular example, to become is an object, means infinitive functions as an object. And last, as a complement. Example, his object is to go to college. In the particular example, to go is act as a complement of the particular example, means infinitive act as a subject, verb, subject, object and complement also. Like this, infinitive conveys orders, instructions or plans also. Conveys orders. Example, you are to report the manager. Then conveys instructions. Lights are to be put off by 10 p.m. In the particular example, he gives instructions to be put is the instruction. So it conveys instructions. And third, conveys plans. See the example. Our group is to start function next month. To start is plan of starting. In the example, it conveys plans. An infinitive can act as an adjective also. Like this, here are some sweet milk to eat. To eat is infinitive, act as an adjective. Example, an infinitive can act as an adverb also. In the example, we play to win. Play to win as an adverb. It act as an adverb also. Infinitive can't change in every tense. Means infinitive कोणत्याही काळामध्ये infinitive चे रूप बदलत नाही. The infinitive is used to transform compound and complex sentences into simple sentences. It is use of infinitive. Then it is something about infinitive. Like this, infinitive is two plus base form of the verb. Then infinitive act as a subject, object and complement also. Like this, what is meant by gerund? We call it verbal noun. definition of gerund is, a gerund is a verb form that ends ing and is used as a noun. Very simple definition. Infinitive used as a subject, object and complement also. Like this, gerund also act as a subject. For example, reading and writing makes man perfect. In the particular example, gerund act as a subject. Another example, reading English is easy. Read plus ing means gerund act as a subject also. Like this, gerund is used act as an object. For example, I like singing. Sing plus ing means gerund. And in the particular example, I like singing act as an object. I like swimming. Like this, swimming is gerund. And in the particular example, it act as object. Her hobby is painting also. But one note for you, there is slack difference between gerund and present participle. In the gerund, there is a feature of verb and noun. And in present participle, there is verb and adjective also. Means there is a slack difference between gerund and present participle. Third is participles. We call it verbal adjective. There are two types of participles. First one, present participle, and second, past participle. First one, present participle. In the present participle, we have to add ing to the verb. For example, come plus ing is equal to coming. Run plus ing is equal to running. It is partly a verb and partly an adjective. Uses of present participle. First use, to make present, past, future continuous tense. For example, I am reading a newspaper. Second use, present participle used as an adjective. It is used as verbal adjective. Example, I saw a dancing girl. I saw a burning train. A roaring stone gathers no mass. I heard the wheeling sound. In the particular example, dancing, burning, barking, rolling, whirling, these are examples of present participle act as adjective. So these are usage of present participle used as a subject. In the example, running is a good exercise. Means, in the particular example, run plus ing is present participle act as a subject. Then second type, past participle. Gone, taken, written, played. These are examples of past participle. It is used to make perfect continuous, perfect past and perfect future tense. For example, I have gone, I had written, I shall have gone. These are examples of past participle. Second use of past participle is past participle used as an adjective. For example, I saw a dead man. This is a painted house. In these examples, dead, painted act as an adjective. So, past participle used as an adjective. विद्यार्थी मित्रांनो, एक्सरसाइज या सेक्शन मध्ये आपण इन्फिनिटिव आणि जिरंड याचा उपयोग आणि याचे एक्झाम्पल्स आपण पाहणार आहोत. येत्या 12वीच्या बोर्ड परीक्षेच्या प्रश्नपत्रिकेमध्ये प्रत्येक प्रश्नपत्रिकेमध्ये हा प्रश्न येतो. तो कशा पद्धतीचा असतो? एक तर इन्फिनिटिवचे जिरंड करा किंवा जिरंडचे इन्फिनिटिव करा किंवा इन्फिनिटिव किंवा जिरंडचे फंक्शन सांगा अशा पद्धतीचा येतो. तर या एक्सरसाइज सेक्शन मध्ये आपण काही एक्झाम्पल्स पाहणार आहोत आणि 2014 पासून प्रत्येक बोर्ड प्रश्नपत्रिकेमध्ये जे काही एक्झाम्पल्स आलेले आहेत ते मी तुम्हाला मुद्दाम सरावासाठी या ठिकाणी देणार आहे की ज्याचा आपल्या येणाऱ्या वार्षिक परीक्षेसाठी एकतर सराव हवा आणि त्यामधून आपल्याला अतिशय सोपा इन्फिनिटिव आणि जिरंड हा टॉपिक आपल्याला पूर्णपणे समजावा ही एक माझी म्हणजे तळमळ आहे. सी द फर्स्ट एक्झाम्पल. करेज इज स्टिकिंग टू युअर पोस्ट इन डेंजर. इन ब्रॅकेट मेक यूज ऑफ द इन्फिनिटिव अँड रिराईट द सेंटेन्स. आन्सर इज करेज इज टू स्टिक टू युअर पोस्ट इन डेंजर. मीन्स इन द पर्टिक्युलर एक्झाम्पल स्टिकिंग इज जिरन अँड यू हॅव टू मेक इन्फिनिटिव मीन्स ऑटोमॅटिकली इट विल बिकम टू स्टिक. व्हेरी इझी. सेकंड एक्झाम्पल. आय लाईक टू चेक माय आन्सर बुक बिफोर आय सबमिट इट. दिस इज एक्झाम्पल ऑफ इन्फिनिटिव बिकॉज टू चेक अँड ऑटोमॅटिकली वी हॅव टू मेक जिरन. आय लाईक चेकिंग माय आन्सर बुक बिफोर आय सबमिट इट. देन एक्झाम्पल फ्रॉम फेब्रुवारी 2019 अँड एक्झाम्पल इज इन्सेक्ट्स हॅव ऑलरेडी अडॉप्टेड द टॅक्टिक ऑफ डिसगाईज टू एस्केप फ्रॉम द क्लचेस ऑफ देअर प्रीडेटर्स. इन ब्रॅकेट रिप्लेस इन्फिनिटिव विथ जिरंड अँड रिराईट. सो सेम सेंटेन्स. इन्सेक्ट्स हॅव ऑलरेडी अडॉप्टेड द टॅक्टिक ऑफ डिसगाईज फॉर escaping because to escape became escaping from the clutches of their predators. Another example from July 2016. To read a lot is essential. In bracket rewrite using the gerund form of the underlying word. Answer is reading a lot is essential. Next example, which was in February 2016. She is rather unabashed about walking up past noon on a daily basis. In bracket, rewrite the sentence using infinitive form of the underlined word. Then answer is, she is rather unabashed about to walk up past noon on a daily basis. Next example was in October 2015. Gandhiji brushed aside adulation to remain a free nobody, which was in October 2016. Then answer. Gandhiji brushed aside adulation for remaining a free nobody. Then next example, which was in March 2015. The school was excellent in climbing. In bracket, mention the function of the underlying gerund. Answer, it is the object of the preposition in. And last example, I went around the village saying goodbye to my friends, in bracket, rewrite it using the infinitive form of the underlined word, which was in October 2014. Answer, I went around the village to say goodbye to my friends. Last example is from March 2014. Chaitanya offered to buy the tickets for us, in bracket, rewrite it using ing form of the underlying part. Answer is, Chaitanya offered buying the tickets for us, to buy become buying. These are examples from various question papers and it is for only one mark. My dear students, wish you best of luck for your HSC exam.